Greetings. Welcome to the Militant Negro YouTube channel, and I am the Militant Negro. There are a couple of issues I want to talk to this morning. I want to address something that's really bothering me. Excuse me. It appears that while Barack Obama is globetrotting across Europe, he's now currently in Greece, from what I understand. We have a situation in North Dakota where the Standing Rock Sioux, the protesters, who are out there diligently protesting the desecration of their sacred burial ground and the contamination of their drinking water, these human beings are being sprayed with water from water cannons in 23 degree temperatures. There are hypothermia fears among the Dakota Access Pipeline protesters as cops soak up to 400 of them with water cannons in freezing temperatures. And of course, tensions are mounting very high at the Standing Rock Reservation. Law enforcement officials in North Dakota have deployed tear gas and water hoses against hundreds of activists protesting against the Dakota Access Pipeline. This Dakota Access Pipeline is going to contaminate the Standing Rock Sioux's water supply, as well as these people are going to have their sacred burial grounds dug up for this pipeline to be built. Protesters also reported being hit with rubber bullets and percussion grenades on a bridge that is just north of the encampments that were established by the indigenous and environmental activists who don't want that pipeline there. LaDonna Brave Bull Allard said they were attacked with water cannons. She's a Standing Rock Sioux tribal member and founder of the Sacred Stone Camp. She goes on to say it is 23 degrees and we've been hit with mace and rubber bullets and pepper spray, etc. They are being trapped and attacked. And she says she asked for people's prayers. Now, I don't know what prayer is going to do, but all this is happening in North Dakota, okay? Understand, North Dakota is in the United States of America. It's not Lebanon. It's not Beirut. It's not Afghanistan, Iran, or Iraq. It's not Palestine. It's not Yemen. It is not Syria. It's the United States of America. And right at this moment, militarized mercenary police forces are out there spraying human beings with water. And it's 23 degrees. And in case you don't know, water freezes at 32 degrees and below. So these human beings, these brothers and sisters of ours, of yours and mine, Native Americans, who have already endured genocide and massacre to the tune of 100 million, are being sprayed with freezing water. As soon as that water hits the atmosphere, the temperature, the air, it drops below freezing as it has, it freezes. So when this water hits the Standing Rock Sioux's skin and clothes and hair, it turns to ice. At that moment, hypothermia is a real serious concern. And there are children present because this pipeline affects everybody in that area. Kids, babies, men, women, they're being affected by this pipeline and they are now all being sprayed with freezing water from water cannons. And earlier, I found out that some of this water was treated with tear gas. So it not only will freeze when it hits their skin and their hair and clothes, it contains tear gas, which is an irritant. This is in America, people. And what really kills me about all of this are two things, actually. Our president, Barack Obama, left the United States to travel abroad so he could build up his legacy before he leaves office, knowingly aware that this shit is happening. These protests didn't start yesterday. These protests didn't start last week. These protests have been going on since as far back as I can remember in July, August, September. And this man, this president, who sold us a line of bullshit in 2008 and again in 2012, got on Air Force One and flew his monkey ass out of the United States, leaving this situation in North Dakota in the hands of North Dakota state officials who don't give a shit. If this doesn't bother you, there's something wrong with you. Okay? Seriously. Human beings treated like cattle. Handcuffed. Maced. Pepper sprayed. Tear gassed. They've had numbers written on their arms to identify them. Just like the Jewish people did in Nazi Germany. They are put in cages. And I'm not talking about cells. I'm talking about cages that you would put a wild animal in. These people are simply trying to protect what is rightfully theirs. We're busy protesting Donald Trump. We're busy protesting dumb shit. But we're not busy protesting this. We're not concerned with Native Americans, Standing Rock Sioux, the water protectors. That's not a concern of ours. We're concerned with Donald Trump. We're upset with Mike Pence, who went to a musical, a play entitled Hamilton, where the actors and actresses got on his ass about what? They have no idea. Because the man ain't vice president yet. He's vice president-elect. Meaning he has not been sworn into office. Nothing he does at this moment matters. But they're busy protesting Pence and Trump. While the Native Americans, defending their homeland, their tribal land, are being ignored. All across America, all across the states in America, are protesters protesting Donald Trump and Mike Pence and whoever they decide to select for their cabinet. Hell, I even read something the other day where somebody speculated on who Donald Trump was going to choose for the Supreme Court. And the man is not even president yet. He's president-elect. So while all of the people in America are focused on the election results and the presidency and vice presidency of Trump and Pence, the Native Americans are being sprayed with freezing water in 23 degree temperatures, laced with mace and tear gas. And nobody gives a fuck. I heard about this latest incident of using water cannons on defenseless, weaponless, again, peaceful protesters through social media. Nowhere have I seen this on the major news networks. Let me run down that list for you. ABC, NBC, CBS, PBS, NPR, CNN, Fox, MSNBC. I haven't seen any of this stuff on these stations. Not one word of it. Everyday common human beings like you and I are live streaming this shit as it happens. using their own finances and their own equipment. They are live streaming this back on social media. That is how I heard about it. That is how I saw it. There were videos posted on YouTube. And we're asleep about this. We don't care. Doesn't concern us. I can't stress enough. Human beings, living, breathing human beings, like you and I, are being persecuted, abused. It amounts to torture to me to have water cannons shot at you in 23 degree temperatures. That is torture. But we're allowing it to happen because we're too busy with Trump and Pence and whatever it is that they're doing. We're being manipulated and controlled by the media because the media is feeding us the garbage they want us to digest. While other things are going on that are much more important, there are incidents and current events that are happening that we are unaware of, and we cannot be unaware of them by just getting on the internet and researching, investigating for ourselves. We are a dumbass society. This is happening right now in our backyard. The water protectors and the Standing Rock Sioux are being tortured. And we are doing nothing about it. We're concerned about Black Friday, which brings me to my next issue, Black Friday. There's a brother who has a YouTube channel called The Jedi. Now, The Jedi is a very informed, knowledgeable, deep brother. And he explains on his YouTube channel, in a YouTube video, exactly what Black Friday means. Now, I used to think the term Black Friday meant businesses and establishments were in the black financially because of the sales that they made on Black Friday. Because you could either be in the black or the red, depending on your profit margins. And I thought Black Friday was in reference to that, being in the black and not in the red. Come to find out a couple of years ago, Black Friday is a slave trade term, symbolizing and referring to slave trade day, where slaves were taken to the markets and the centers and the squares and towns and sold. And because they were black, skin color wise, and because it was a Friday when these usually happen, hence the term Black Friday. So all you people, no matter what your race, religion, culture, ethnicity, you are participating in a slave auction on Black Friday. Only difference is you're putting your dollars into the pockets of businesses and manufacturers instead of slave owners. But you're really a slave anyway because you're a slave to what they're selling you. You're a slave to spending your money on shit you don't need. That's right. We don't need that shit we're going to buy on Black Friday. But we're going to buy it anyway, because we've been programmed to do that, because we're idiots. We're celebrating a holiday on Thursday called Thanksgiving, which is a holiday to commemorate the massacre and slaughter and genocide of 100 million indigenous Native Americans. That is what Thanksgiving is. It's a celebration of the first meal between pilgrims and Native Americans, when the pilgrims came bearing gifts and food with the knife in their hands behind their back. This was a let's get together, a greet and meet, a welcome to the neighborhood bullshit thing, so they could win the trust of Native Americans who didn't know anything about these Caucasian people. Didn't know what devils they were. So that's what Thanksgiving is. It's a celebration of the massacre the Holocaust, if you will, of Native American indigenous people. And it's been marketed as a great American holiday, when in actuality, it's a great American feast celebrating the killing of human life. You think about that when you sit down to your turkey and your sweet potato pies and your pumpkin pies and your cobblers and your stuffing and all that other shit. Think about that, what it is you're celebrating. But back to back Black Friday, the Jedi has this video on his YouTube channel which explains in detail where the term Black Friday comes from. So after you celebrate that fake, phony, horrendous, horrific holiday of Thanksgiving, which is on a Thursday, and that next day, which is a Friday, you're going to turn right around and go out and spend all your money on a slave trading day. And you think America's not fucked up? Okay, that's fucked up. One day we're eating turkey in celebration of the killing of Native Americans, and the next day we're going to spend our money in celebrating the slave trade of people of color, of Africans. Yeah, think about that. Put that in your pipe and smoke it. Check him out, the Jedi. I'm going to put a link to his YouTube channel and a link to this specific YouTube video in the description box below. So you can click on that, give him a listen. Subscribe to his channel if you like what he says. Give him a thumbs up. Let him know you appreciate his work. Because as I heard him say in one of his videos today, it's hard work making these videos. It's not easy. A lot of work and effort goes into making them, publishing them, and sharing them around, marketing them, getting them out there. This is work. But I think people do it because they feel a need to inform. So check out the Jedi. See what he's talking about. It's worth your time. Knowledge is empowering. We all need knowledge. Another thing I'm going to hit on while I've got my mind on it. We're out there protesting the Trump presidency to come. But we are no longer raising our voices about the execution and the death of human beings by law enforcement. This year alone, 2016, 1,025 dead at the hands of law enforcement. In the month of November, which is just 21 days old as of today, there have been 62 human beings killed by law enforcement. 62 in 21 days. 1,025 in the 12 months of the year. And this month is not over with yet. I mean, 11 months of the year. We've got one more month to go in this year. And I think last year we hit 1,204 dead with 30 plus days left. We are at 1,025. That's something to think about. But you know what? Nobody's protesting that. That's another thing we're not protesting. We're not protesting cops killing human beings, whether they need to kill them or not. That's a lot of people dead. That's a lot of families and friends and acquaintances and neighbors that are dead. And some of them, a lot of them, are unarmed. And even more of them look like me. They're Negro or they're Latino. They're women. They're mentally ill people. I can't stress this enough. Nobody's protesting that right now. It's all quiet on the genocide front from cops killing people. Silent as crickets. You know, the media is not reporting on that. But there is a website that I use exclusively that tells you on a daily basis how many people police officers and law enforcement kill. and that site is called killedbypolice.net. I'll repeat it, killedbypolice.net. And I may just well put that link in the description box as well. Check it out for yourselves. Somebody said that The Guardian has a site that they do that on. I don't trust The Guardian. To me, they're a rag. I trust killedbypolice.net because they have links to every statistic that they have. You can click on the links and check out the actual story. And they update this as it happens. Next, I want to come to us as a human race. We as people. We need to band together. We need unity. There is number in strength. And this is not just a cliche or a saying. There is number in unity. The stronger we are, the more we are. And the more we are, the greater we can be. We can't do this alone. We can't change what's happening in our world alone. We need the help of every one of us. We need to wake up. We need to take off the blinders and the rose-colored glasses and realize this world is in trouble. We are all connected. I can't say that enough. We are all connected. I am my brother's and sister's keeper. I can't say that enough. I can't stress it enough. You've got your head in the sand. You've got your attention focused on other stuff. And right under your nose, people are dying. People are homeless and starving and in need of things. And we are just closing our eyes to it and walking over them, stepping around them in the streets and on the sidewalk, in the doorways. Homeless, hungry people. We use Thanksgiving and Christmas and sometimes maybe Easter as days to be in the spirit of giving. We need to be in the spirit of giving 24/7, 365. You can't just wait until a holiday rolls around to give and to share and to donate. We all have things in our closet that we do not use. Coats, gloves, hats. I know each and every one of us has 3 or 4 blankets. You can't use 3 or 4 blankets at one time. Some blankets have never been used. Give them to the homeless. Please, donate them. Don't take them to a shelter to hand out. Give them yourselves to a homeless individual. Veterans, families, kids, they're homeless and they're out there. And we ignore them on a daily basis. Pack up that stuff in your closet you don't use. Coats, shoes, pants, hats, gloves, scarves. Go through your drawers. All that stuff you don't use, you haven't worn, you can no longer fit, give it away. There are people out there who can use it. You give it to Goodwill, they want to charge people for it and sell it. Give it to the homeless yourself. Hand it to them. Smile at them. Ask them how they're doing. Spend a few minutes talking to them. These are human beings who crave a human touch. No matter what people tell you, humans need and desire human touch, human contact. You can do this. It costs you nothing. I'm not asking you to donate your money. I'm just asking you to donate what you don't need, a little time. When you sit down at your table to celebrate that Thanksgiving that is really a celebration of murder, think about the people in Standing Rock who could use you standing with them. I said in an earlier video, get in your cars, go down to North Dakota, show your support, show your love. And if you can't do that, donate a couple of bucks to their cause. Look up online how to donate to Standing Rock. Get in your cars and go down there and unify with those people. This holiday season is always about giving, We need to do that same type of giving every month of the year. We think we're not connected, but we are connected to the entire planet. We're all connected. If a bomb falls on a child in Syria, we feel that. Yemen, Syria, Afghanistan, Iran, Iraq, Beirut, Lebanon, Africa, New Zealand, Mexico. These people are hurting. And while we sit in our homes and we are comfortable, 3/4 of the world is not comfortable. I am appealing to the humanity in humans. Get out there and make a difference. Action. Mr. Jedi said tonight on a video I listened to, action is the only thing that changes anything. You have to get off your asses and take action in some way. Little things mean a lot. Little things mean a lot. We have to stop things from going on that are not right. Our parents taught us right and wrong and the difference. And as adults, we have to do what we know is right. We can't sit by and allow those people in North Dakota to be treated and abused and tortured as if they are animals and criminals and terrorists. You have militarized mercenary police treating them like, I don't know what the word is I want to use, while the Bundys occupied a nature wildlife reserve and nothing happened to them for months. They stood back and let those people do whatever the hell they want to do, and they were armed. These Native Americans in North Dakota are unarmed, peaceful, just protesting for their very survival, because without water, you die. I've said it before and I'm going to say it again and I'm going to continue to say it. We are protesting the wrong shit when we protest Donald Trump and Mike Pence and anything Trump is doing or said he's going to do or plans to do. Okay? That ain't important. What's important is life being taken via cops, via mercenary police force, via anything, war. There's war everywhere. And we do nothing about it. We sit on our hands. We rather protest Mike Pence going to a musical than protest the massacres going on across this globe due to war. We're more concerned with questioning a man viewing a play because he won an election than we are questioning our president supporting Israel as they kill millions of Palestinians. There's something fucked up about that, don't you think? We want to get all up in Donald Trump's face, but we won't say anything to Hillary Clinton about the mass deaths she caused while she was Secretary of State. There's something wrong here. Our focus is in the wrong place. We need to get unified, people. We need to stand up for what's right. We need a call to action, and we need to do something instead of being blind and silent and choosing to protest bullshit and not protest what's vitally important. This Thanksgiving, don't celebrate. Don't eat a feast to the death and massacre of millions of Native Americans. Don't participate in something that celebrates death. This Friday, don't spend your money. It's slave trade day. Keep it in your pockets. I love you guys. I hope we all have a great November. Peace out. Namaste. Remember what I said. We need to keep ourselves safe. We need to stay together. We need unity.